Tonight, Denver City Council is moving forward with a plan to renovate the Loretto Heights campus.
The campus in Southwest Denver dates back to 1891 and could soon include affordable housing and retail space. And Denver 7's Jessica Porter is here. So under the council's plan, Jessica, there are some parts of the campus that will remain untouched.
Yeah, well, according to the developer, they say that there is a covenant that keeps portions of that plan, like the administration building and the cemetery, from ever being touched or demolished. So at the meeting tonight, not only did the majority of city council vote for this plan, but the majority of public speakers were in favor of it as well. Many believe this plan will bring good investments to Southwest Denver, while others will be watching the developer very closely.
I was able to actually teach a course there when the university was still in operation, and I just deeply fell in love with the campus.
Loretto Heights could be entering a new era with a plan to turn this former Catholic school into a community.
I think this is the best small area plan that the city of Denver has ever created.
Apartments and condos are planned along South Federal Boulevard, traditional single unit homes on the west side, and the iconic administration building could become a hub of commercial and retail space.
I think the plan as a whole is a great vision of what the community wants to see, and so specifically the open space, the affordable housing, the need for this closed campus to now be opened up to the public around it, so it's going to become a community asset.
There are concerns for the 120-year-old campus, like the traffic that comes with adding 2,500 new people living in the area, and gentrification that comes with building high-rises.
By not allowing these buildings to be constructed higher, you're also looking at restricting the number of penthouses and the number of units that can be priced very, very high.
The developer Westside Investment Partners says they are committed to preserving the administration building and cemetery, but many want something more official than a promise.
We're not going anywhere. Regardless of what happens this evening, we're going to be there monitoring what the developer is doing.
And this is just the first step of many for this developer. They still need to get zoning documents and historic preservation approvals, as well as site plans. So it could be months or even years before they ever break ground on new construction.
It is a gem.
It really is.
Beautiful building.
Thanks, Jessica.
Thank you, Jess.